Hello guys, Zander here and welcome back to a new video. If you follow my channel, then you must have seen a video back in January 2020 where I talked about the Zephyrus G14 and I said in that video that Zephyrus G14 is my favorite laptop of 2020. I mean, it's going to be. And after using it, I have the same opinion. G14 is going to be my go-to recommendation if you have the budget and if you are a gamer or a content creator. Like, it's so much easier to recommend now after actually using the laptop. In this video, we'll talk about my experience, what you get, what's the pricing, the most important thing. So without further delay, let's get started. So the base variant of G14 will start at 89,000 as of shooting this video, which will be without Anime Matrix. If you do not know what Anime Matrix is, then on the G14, you get a variant, like you have a choice to go with this type of variant where you will get 1000 plus LED lights and you can customize them according to your need. Like you can add a GIF, you can add an image, you can add your own text and things like that. So without this Anime Matrix, it will start at 89,000 rupees, and the base variant with Anime Matrix will start at about 98,000 rupees, and the highest end variant with 3900 HS RTX 2060 will start at 161,000 rupees. By the way, all the detailed pricing will be written in the description box below and all the necessary links to those respective laptops will be present there as well. Now let's talk about the specifications, because obviously that's the most important thing. I have to pull out my phone because there are a lot of variants that you need to know. Now there are two CPU variants, Ryzen 5 4600HS and Ryzen 7 4800HS. You can get either GTX 1650, or if you have budget of more than 1 lakh rupees, then you can get GTX 1650 Ti. But one thing which I'm really glad about, that Asus did not compromise on the build quality, battery life, charging solution or keyboard or anything like that. Everything was so good on this device. Now you also get an option of Ryzen 7 4800HS and Ryzen 9 4900HS. These two CPUs can be paired with GTX 1660 Ti or RTX 2060. Now who should go with RTX 2060 and who should go with 1660 Ti? Assuming you don't have budget for 2060 and you are a content creator who edits a lot of videos, I feel like GTX 1660 Ti should be more than enough in a laptop. 2060 will definitely, like literally will perform better. It's just that you don't have budget for that. So for all those content creators who are planning to buy the G14, then I would highly recommend you to get a better CPU rather than getting a better GPU. But if you are a gamer, then get a better GPU as compared to getting a better CPU, because all these CPUs are like will perform very good in gaming. Getting better GPU will result in much better gaming performance, and for content creators that will happen for CPU. Now let's talk about all the other features which are going to be literally the same for base variant as well as the top end variant. You can upgrade the RAM up to 32 GB. By the way, you get a 3200 megahertz DDR4 RAM. The least that you can get is a 512 GB variant. That's a great thing. There is extra slot to add another SSD. Not just that, it is NVMe M.2 SSD based on PCIe 3.0. Speed and boot times are fantastic on this device. You also get a backlit keyboard and three variants of the display. You can either get 1080p 60Hz display, 1080p 120Hz display, or you can get 1440p 60Hz display. For content creators, 1440p 60Hz display is like ideal because you don't do gaming, so 120Hz is not really needed. If you are a gamer, you know 120Hz is your thing and you should definitely go for that. Now talking about the display itself, the viewing angles are fantastic because it's an IPS panel, non-glare IPS panel, 100% sRGB. Not just that, the device comes with backlit keyboard and there are two 2.5 watt speakers which are just below the keyboard, and the laptop supports Dolby Atmos. The sound quality experience on the laptop was A+. You can definitely edit videos with Zephyrus G14 by using these speakers. But one good thing that I noticed about the G14 is that it's not that flashy as you'd expect from an ROG laptop. Basically, there is no major RGB, literally no RGB that I can think of on the laptop. So if you get a version without Anime Matrix, or even if you get one with Anime Matrix, you can write your name or your company's name, maybe, I don't know, and it still looks great. It looks very professional. It doesn't give that feeling that the person is gamer. I mean, is there anything wrong being a gamer? I don't really know. My point is, the laptop looks professional as well as gamery at the same time. You also get 150 watt power adapter in the base variant and 180 watt power adapter in all the other variants, which is crazy, and it's actually necessary if you are planning to game with RTX 2060 and 3900HS at full brightness and keyboard lights turned to maximum. 180 watt is necessary. The laptop obviously supports USB Type-C PD charging up to 65 watts, which is good and all. But when you're going to do gaming with all these graphics card, like even the base variant 1650 consumes 50 watt, like can consume up to 50 watt, forget CPU, keyboard, display and everything. So the USB Type-C PD charging is good enough for normal day-to-day life work, but may not be enough for gaming. So for that, you will have to use the power brick, because if you connect the USB Type-C PD charger, then and you're playing games, after some time, you'll realize that the battery went from 40 to 30. Laptop is going to consume so much of energy, and that's how laptops perform. But at least you get an option to charge the device via the Type-C port, and you can do that only with the one USB Type-C port, and luckily that's present on the power adapter side as well. I mean, where you will connect the power adapter, on that side only that USB Type-C port is present, so it's not confusing konsa USB Type-C port pe laga. Job well done. When it comes to USB ports, there are two USB 3.2 Gen 2 ports, two USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports, and one HDMI 2.0b. This is a full HDMI port, 3.5mm headphone jack, and one Kensington lock as well. And I guess that's pretty much it for the G14 and its specifications and pricing. What do I think and what my experience was like? Using the G14 was a breeze. I mean, build quality on this device is actually so good. After moving from Mi Notebook and Asus VivoBook, I was able to feel that G14 is actually premium. The laptop chassis is made out of magnesium, which is a very sturdy material. I tried pressing on it, but it doesn't bend at all. So build quality is something you do not have to worry about. Hinge mechanism is definitely one of my favorites. I feel like every other laptop should have it. When it comes to heavy gaming, the laptop definitely became warm. I mean, that's obviously going to happen, but it was not overheating and throttling at times. That was not the case. While watching YouTube videos, Netflix and chilling, like me by myself, the laptop did not overheat there. Asus claims a long battery life, but I was able to get about 5 to 6 hours of battery life only. To get 8 to 9 hours of battery life, I had to uninstall some of the bloatware which was present on the laptop. I mean, disable few things. There is a Reddit thread which I'll link in the description box below, which I got to know from someone else's YouTube video when I was watching some other people's G14 reviews. When I did that, I actually got a better battery life. So if you're planning to buy G14, then the thread will be linked in the description box below. And I guess that's pretty much it for the Asus Zephyrus G14. I feel like this is one of the best laptops to go for if you are a content creator, hands down. Ryzen 4000 series CPUs are terrific when it comes to performance. If you are a gamer, like very high-end gamer, then I feel like you will feel limited by the RTX 2060, considering there are laptops with Intel CPUs and RTX 2070. If you have a very high budget, like 2 lakh, 2 lakh 50 thousand rupees, G14 is limited only by the GPU, which is RTX 2060. If that's more than enough for you, then G14 feels like one of the best laptops that I can easily recommend to anyone whose budget comes around G14's pricing. And I guess that's pretty much it for this particular video. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and press the bell icon so that you will get notified next time I upload a video like this one. If you have any doubts, you can tweet it to me at @dhananjay_tech as well. So yeah, thank you guys. Thank you for watching. Now, if you're wondering why there is no gaming and why I did not show Premiere Pro timings, renders and everything, that's my mistake actually. I did everything, like I did gaming. Usually when we test things, we run these things without camera, like we test ourselves, like to make sure all everything is updated and driver settings and everything is correct. And then we test it again on camera while recording it. Obviously my mistake, the person who was going to pick up the G14 came below my building and I had like 5 minutes to do everything. So unfortunately I could not shoot it on camera, but I'll definitely try my best to get the laptop once again from Asus to test in detail. Like then in that video, I'll talk about gaming, Premiere Pro performance and everything like that. So don't worry. I guess that's it. I feel really bad that I could not do it on camera. I can definitely say Premiere Pro performance is top notch. By the way, the variant that I had came with 3900HS and RTX 2060. Premiere Pro performance was bonkers. One of the best I have used on a laptop for sure. You can literally close your eyes and go for G14.